Beneath the surface of our modern technological marvels lies a group of elements most people have never heard of, yet can't live without. Rare earth elements, despite their misleading name, are crucial components in everything from your smartphone to advanced military equipment. But there's a catch. One country dominates their production and processing, holding immense power over global supply chains and potentially geopolitics. Welcome to the world of rare earth elements, where China reigns supreme. In this deep dive, we'll explore what these elements are, why they're so important, and how China came to control this critical industry. We'll uncover the strategic decisions, economic factors, and geopolitical implications that have shaped this landscape, and consider what the future might hold for rare earth elements and the technologies that depend on them. China currently controls about 60% of the world's rare earth element production, and processes a whopping 85% of them. But what exactly are rare earth elements, and why should we care? Rare earth elements, or REEs, are a group of 17 metallic elements that have become indispensable in our modern world. Despite their name, these elements aren't actually rare in the Earth's crust. However, they're often difficult and expensive to extract and process, which has led to their limited production in many parts of the world. These elements, with names like neodymium or dysprosium and terbium, might not be household names, but they're essential components in many technologies we use every day. They're used in computer hard drives, electric vehicle motors, and even in military equipment like precision-guided missiles. In fact, your iPhone alone contains 8 different rare earth elements. They're also vital for defense hardware, with each F-35 fighter jet requiring about 920 pounds of REEs. The unique properties of rare earth elements, particularly their magnetic and conductive characteristics, make them irreplaceable in many high-tech applications. As we continue to advance technologically and push for cleaner energy solutions, the demand for these elements is only expected to grow. When we look at the rare earth industry today, one country stands out above all others: China. China's dominance in this sector didn't happen overnight. It's the result of decades of strategic planning and policies that have positioned China at the center of this critical industry. The story begins in 1927, when rare earth deposits were discovered in Inner Mongolia. Recognizing the potential importance of these resources, China began investing heavily in rare earth research and development. This early start gave China a significant advantage as the importance of rare earth grew with technological advancements. A crucial turning point came in 1990, when China declared rare earths as a protected and strategic mineral. This designation wasn't just a formality, it came with real policy implications. Projects involving rare earth mining and processing now required approval from the highest levels of government. Foreign investors were limited to joint ventures with Chinese firms, ensuring that China maintained control over the industry even as it welcomed foreign expertise and capital. China didn't stop at controlling the mining and processing of rare earths within its borders. It also implemented strategic export controls. The government introduced export quotas and taxes, which served multiple purposes. These measures protected the domestic supply of rare earths for Chinese manufacturers and encouraged the development of downstream industries within China. By making it more expensive to export raw materials, China incentivized companies to set up their manufacturing operations within its borders, further strengthening its position in the global supply chain. Fast forward to today, and China's control is staggering. They account for 70% of global rare earth mining, refine 89% of neodymium and praseodymium, and produce 92% of rare earth magnets. According to a study from the Brookings Institution, China presently produces some 60% of the world's rare earth elements and processes 85% of them. This means that even rare earths mined in other countries often end up being processed in China. But how did China achieve this level of dominance? There are several factors at play. First, China declared rare earths a protected resource in 1990, limiting foreign involvement. Second, China's less stringent environmental regulations have played a role in its dominance. Processing rare earths can be an environmentally damaging process, and China's more relaxed approach to environmental protection has made it cheaper to process rare earths here compared to countries with stricter regulations. Third, China invested heavily in research and development, creating state-owned mining labs and REE-focused university programs. Lastly, even rare earths mined elsewhere often end up being processed in China due to global supply chains. It's worth noting that China's dominance isn't due to having all the world's rare earth deposits. In fact, China has about 34% of global reserves, with countries like Vietnam, Russia, and Brazil also having significant deposits. The reliance of other countries on China for these critical materials is profound. The United States, despite being a technological superpower, imported around 3/4 of its rare earth elements from China in 2019. The situation in Europe is even more stark, with the European Union acquiring 98% of its rare earth minerals from China. China's dominance in the rare earth industry isn't just an economic issue. It has significant geopolitical implications as well. Perhaps the most concerning aspect for many countries is the potential for China to use its rare earth dominance as a political tool. We've already seen an example of this in action. In 2010, during a dispute with Japan, China restricted rare earth exports, causing global prices to skyrocket by over 300%. This wake-up call has spurred other countries into action. The US, Japan, and European nations are now investing in their own rare earth production and processing capabilities. For instance, the US-based MP Materials mines rare earths in California, and Japan has invested in Australia's Lynas Corporation to secure its supply. The United States, once self-sufficient in REEs, now has only one operating mine, the Mountain Pass mine in California's Mojave Desert. Even what it brings out of the earth, it ships to China for the environmentally fraught business of separation and refinement. This might be a smart move, as China has, as of December 2024, banned exports of a number of critical rare earth elements to the United States in the ongoing trade tensions between the superpowers. For countries like the United States, the dependence on China for rare earths is also a national security concern. Many advanced military technologies rely on rare earth elements. The fact that a potential geopolitical rival controls the supply of these critical materials is a source of significant unease for military planners and policymakers. The push for green technologies is driving up demand for rare earths. Global demand for some REEs is expected to grow by almost 50% by mid-century. This is putting pressure on both China and its competitors. China isn't standing still. In December of 2021, they created the China Rare Earth Group, consolidating several state-owned enterprises to enhance control over the industry. This mega conglomerate is estimated to account for nearly 2/3 of the country's heavy rare earth supplies and around 1/4 of global mineral-bearing rare earth elements. This move allows China to better manage production, control prices, and respond to global market dynamics. But the future isn't set in stone. Some experts argue that China is unlikely to use rare earths as a wild card in geopolitical struggles, as it has benefited greatly from globalization. Others suggest that Western nations have about 5 years to reduce their dependence on Chinese rare earths before China could effectively use them for economic coercion. The global community is taking notice. Japan has proposed a plan to the G7 group of developed economies to find and finance REE mining and refining operations in Africa and Latin America. This is understandable given that Beijing has already imposed 2 REE bans on Japan in recent years. On the policy front, many countries have designated rare earths as critical minerals. This designation often comes with increased funding and support for their development. In the United States, rare earths have been added to the list of minerals deemed critical to economic and national security, freeing up resources for their development. China's dominance extends beyond its borders. Chinese rare earth companies are partnering with foreign governments and acquiring mining contracts from Africa to Asia. In Burma's Kachin state, over $1 billion worth of rare earths were exported to China between May 2017 and October 2021. In the Democratic Republic of Congo, Chinese investors control an estimated 70% of the mines. However, China's grip on the rare earth market might be loosening. Recent developments suggest a shift in the global landscape. For instance, Tesla recently announced plans for next-generation motors using rare earth-free magnets. While some industry experts believe this will have minimal effect, others see it as a revolutionary move. Moreover, the US and Europe are making strides to decrease their dependence on China. The United States Department of Defense granted a $120 million contract to Australia's Lynas Rare Earths to construct a heavy rare earths separation facility in Texas. Japan has also fortified its rare earth supply chain by increasing investments in Lynas, successfully decreasing its rare earth dependence on China from over 90% to 58% within a decade. Despite these efforts, China continues to defend its monopoly. It has aggressively expanded its international markets by acquiring stakes in some of the largest mining companies like MP Materials in the US and Vitals Metals in Australia. China's tech system and production quota are highly meticulous, with a 13% VAT imposed on magnets, metals, and oxides. This gives domestic rare earth product manufacturers a 13% cost advantage in the supply chain over foreign competitors. Let's consider the broader implications. The rare earth story is far from over. As the world pushes for greener technologies and nations strive for technological superiority, the competition for these critical elements will only intensify. Reducing dependence on China for rare earths is a challenging and long-term process. China's established infrastructure, expertise, and cost advantages make it difficult for other countries to compete in the short term. Moreover, the environmental challenges associated with rare earth mining and processing remain a significant hurdle. Countries with stricter environmental regulations may struggle to develop their rare earth industries in a cost-effective and sustainable manner. However, the growing recognition of the strategic importance of rare earths is likely to drive continued investment and innovation in the sector. As demand for technologies that rely on rare earths continues to grow, particularly in areas like renewable energy and electric vehicles, the incentives for developing alternative supplies will only increase. The coming years will be crucial in determining the future of the rare earth industry. Will China maintain its dominance, or will other countries successfully develop their own rare earth capabilities? Will environmental concerns lead to new extraction and processing methods? And how will geopolitical tensions impact the global supply of these critical elements? Thank you for joining me for this in-depth look at China's dominance in the rare earth industry. If you found this video informative, please like and subscribe for more content on geopolitics.